Charlene Nash, and I have been to Africa 3 times, and I have started a 501(c)(3) out of pressure to do something more than just go and have the regular classes. So if you want to get involved with this project or donate money, I'm leaving in another week to spend 2 weeks there to teach agriculture. And these people that I'm working with in Mozambique, are not waiting on a handout. They are very much helping themselves, but they need some more information, they need some training, and they need a boost, and that's what I'm here for. This is the first shot. You can see their land looks about like South Georgia Red Clay or some parts of Tennessee. It's in bad shape. They do all this tilling by hand. They have one implement that they use, and you can see that they need to have my job, in other words, here, is to double their food production, half their labor, with no money, no tools, and no inputs. So that's what we're trying to do over there. That's the one implement that they have to use. And the worst thing that can happen to these people is the president's new initiative for a public-private partnership in which Monsanto, Cargill, and Syngenta have so graciously decided to help. And we're trying to give them the training that will build soil and build production and insulate them from drought and pests and too much water in the rainy season by improving the soil and the nutrients in the soil to improve their diet. GM does not work. It does not work here, it will not work there, and it's the worst technology to come down in a long time. You can see that some of their technology, someone has been here before I have, and shown them about composting and things like this, but it is not done in a way that is really going to improve their soils. I'm trying to teach them the biointensive methods of making beds and intensifying their composting and doing it correctly in a timely manner to improve the humus in the soil, but also the microbes, and the soil gets better every year instead of worse every year. This is a lunchtime with one of the more prosperous farmers whose husband actually works in town, and that makes a difference. This is our classroom after it was repainted and decorated, and we have a nice chalkboard, which we didn't have before. We will be bringing 50 people to the class, and they will be from the surrounding villages, and we are trying to raise $900 to be able to feed those 50 people for 4 days. This is my PowerPoint presentation before the chalkboard went up last August. That's how we talk, kind of like we used to do in second grade with our poster paper, and to give them all the information they need. And even though I'm speaking with an interpreter, they write down every word in Portuguese. This is our little school building. This is their center. It's called, in Portuguese, it's Program for Rural Development. I don't know exactly how to say that. But this picture, your church in your yard with Bermuda grass, that's what this lawn is like, lawn yard. It's hard as a rock, and so we're going to turn that into an agriculture center. Last January, I was supposed to go out to the country to talk to some organic farmers, and we pulled up to this building, and I said, yay, we have internet, we have bathrooms, we have electricity. And we'd already driven 75 kilometers, and they said, oh no, this isn't your building. We've got 25 kilometers more to go. So we drive, there's my classroom. We drove way out, past a little restaurant called the Pink Floyd Restaurant. I thought that was cool. 2-lane sandy dirt road way out in Africa where the houses are hundreds of yards apart. And we had to teach them very quickly in one afternoon how to build proper compost and try to encourage them to make beds, because their fields are huge and they're taking care of these fields by hand, but the crops are very sporadic, so they're weeding this enormous field when they're only growing in probably a third of it and the plants are scattered all about. So you can see everybody was participating and trying to find the greens and the browns to layer it properly and get the moisture applied properly. And this language was Makua. So I was speaking to my Portuguese interpreter, and was speaking to the Makua interpreter, and then telling the people what to do. So I don't know what message they really got. We did the best we could do, but they were hilarious. And that little lady in the green shirt was so funny, and she was telling a joke, and we were all laughing, but nobody knew what we were laughing about. But we were having a really good time. Well, the pile is getting bigger and bigger. When I go back in next Sunday, I will be trying to bring people from Manika's villages all around, and bring in two representatives from each village, and we'll be trying to teach them again how to do that, and we'll how to intensify their agriculture and get the nutrients. I'll be also doing some nutrition education and herbal medicine education, which is what they're very interested in. This is the USAID World Food Program. Those farmers that you just saw building the compost were the organic farmers. And that is another problem over there. When you see our organic labels here, when they're imported, sometimes they think no chemicals and no fertilizers means organic. They do not understand the full meaning of organic, meaning environmental protection and soils being improved and getting better every year. And they knew I was coming back to this village in January, so they built a hasty little bed right there. And this lady with the white shirt on has a dowsing rod there. Last August, I went to visit this very poor farm, and they needed water, and they handed me a dowsing rod, and they said, "Find water." And I'm like, "Find water, okay." I haven't doused in years and years. So I went all over the farm, and I found water, and I showed them how to douse their bodies. And so she asked me about dowsing her body, and I said, "I don't have any bad dowsing rods." And so she pulled hers out that I'd given her 6 months before. Here's my lunch right there, and I didn't know what it was. It was kind of like cake, it was kind of like potato, and that's what it was. I had no idea. I was just glad it wasn't monkey brains. I ate it to be polite, but I was very concerned about what I was eating. I said, "Oh, I grow that at home, so that's not so bad." But they were very interested in the dowsing and herbal medicine. I found that woman is a curandero in the neighborhood. She grows a lot of the herbs, and she does a lot of healing with the herbs too. So if anybody is interested in donating tonight or interested in more information about Soil Resources Initiative, just contact me. I've got some sheets back there with our information on it. Thank you.